Kevin Eriksson versus Oliver Bennett. Bennett in the Mini. The Mini turned up here a little bit late, and so he was on the back foot in terms of getting it prepped. Straight over the gap jump, Ollie Bennett, to be fair, said it was like his motocross days. Green light for those two, and Ollie Bennett's got a brilliant start. Put the squeeze on Kevin Eriksson, the run to turn one. Going to shut the door. Liam, you had a little bit of a hand in the Mini.
That was a great job by Bennett to be getting the lead from the outside there. Yeah, it's a great car.
People
engine, engineered by myself, that car is. So
yes,
here he goes again.
The humility is just stacking on.
No, I'm just joking.
No, you're not.
Well, you're not. What a jerk. Who invited him into the commentary box?
I think it's one of you guys.
He's the most humble guy he knows.
If you're wondering how Liam got it, by the way, I text Liam and he didn't reply, so I text Andrea and he was here
His wife. 2 minutes later.
You know how it works.
All joking aside, Bennett goes, takes kind of an awkward line here. This, that momentum, let's see.
Nah, too late on the race.
Not ideal.
Ollie's taking a different line there in the head, but he's the first guy we've seen to go. And then Kevin's got an even better line. That was cool.
He threw his keys at the valet and said, park it up front.
Kevin might have actually fully over-rotated that. Ollie's making too many mistakes here. But Kevin, I think Kevin's had a big half spin in the background. He's not over the tabletop jump at the back. He's a long way back. So Bennett spotters need to see this now.
Yeah. Joker, look at the gap. Go, go, go.
Got to be done, boys. Getting Joker now?
Yeah, 100%. Definitely.
100%.
No, and he's made another mistake.
Ollie, what is happening?
Oh, he's broken the car.
And Liam, Liam, do you want to talk about engineering now?
No Joker. That whoever engineered that car needs to go home.
He's got to go. He's not going
to
go.
No Joker. And look, the gap closes. It was up to 10.2 seconds. As Ollie definitely needs a game.
But now Kevin stopped to the back. So
Kevin's got. So,
now it's going to be really interesting.
Let's take a breath. So basically, Bennett there. I thought he broke on the car. He ran so wide, but Bennett has run wide in all the corners. To be fair to Ollie, I think he's still going to win.
I think he bumped. I think he just bumped the car down.
Down at the end.
The car's not rotating. Yeah. That's the problem. I mean, both when he came in on turn one or into turn two, and then the car's just not rotating. I think. How he wanted to.
He's been going well though. Like he's done some decent times in. I think he was about halfway up the session.
He is struggling with the car turned in. I think you can actually find yourself putting too much rear grip into the chassis, and then you can't rotate the car. It's great to get out the corner, but you can't get into it either. So I'd say at the moment he's got a lot of rear grip around in the chassis.
So running really soft on the back to try
rear
and find
maybe even rear roller off. Rear roller off would give you a lot of rear grip. You'd lose front. You wouldn't be able to get the car to turn in, but you'd get out the corners. But it might work, you know. Like I said,
he's using the handbrake.
The track is so awkward. To attack the track, you can't. So he might have just taken the decision. Listen, I'll find my way into the corner, but I can get out of it at least. Because he is actually getting out of the corner, it's pretty good.
All right, so Ollie Bennett does take that Joker lap, and you can see 27 seconds between him and Kevin Eriksson. Eriksson nowhere part of the picture. He's in a different chapter altogether. But Ollie Bennett, as long as he keeps it tidy, he's going
to
have the picture.
They're on the radio to Ollie. You can see he's backed it off now. When he ran deep in this corner, I was like, this is game over.
Backed it off and gone a bit faster, actually. Backing off looks like he's working better for him.
It's so slippery.
Yeah, it is so slippery. Just chilling a little bit. Maybe not this chill. But chilling a little bit gives you a little bit of a tactic.
So while we wait for Kevin to come round, Liam, what's the score? Looking at the track conditions, knowing tomorrow is probably going to start quite windy and get a bit loose as the day goes on, you're going to go and dial the car in a bit?
I was going to come up here and ask you what you thought, because I have no plan whatsoever.
And you guys, you really talked this up, Liam. Getting that launch from the outside, closing the door, as you said, Andrew.
It's absolutely strong.
But the Pipo engine, it's a very well-known engine. Solberg used it in his build back in the day, and everyone was like, wow, what is this? And it's just such a strong start as well. It's brilliant, isn't it? This was where we thought he'd made a mistake, but look at Kevin, and just that's what I mean. He went all the way round, and I think he thought he was going to style it out, and then, in fact, he's had to go back and give it the figure of eight, cut the corner and rejoin in, and that was 7-8 seconds.
Yeah.
And then Bennett runs wide at the end of the straight. Here's Bennett at the end of the straight. Look, we know it's dusty down there, but watch this. On the brakes and just fully out to the outside. I thought it was broken.
Car really doesn't want to turn in, does it?
No.
Not wanting to turn in.
So you're going to go and have a word as you're such a legendary engineer. You're going to go and just fix it for him straight
away.
Don't
listen to anyone who has anything to do with that.
All things considered, you could drive that car. Your suit matches the car.
It does match the car.
Totes adorbs.
It does.
You guys are adorable.
I hadn't noticed that.